Hello viewers, welcome to our channel Database Concept. Today we are going to learn 7 steps of converting entity relationship diagram to table. This is also known as mapping. Actually, we are converting the conceptual data model into relational schema. Let's start the 7 steps. Step 1. Mapping strong entity types. For each regular entity types on your diagram, create a table. Nominate a primary key for the table. Add the rest of the attributes. So, we convert the employee, department, project entity into table. Then nominate a primary key for them and add the rest of the attributes. Step 2. Mapping weak entity types. For each weak entity types, create a table. The primary key of this table is a combination of the identifier of the parent entity and the identifier of the weak entity. So here we create a separate table for dependent, and the primary key should include the identifier of the parents, that means employee, and the identifier of the dependent table. Step 3. Map binary one-to-many relationships. Primary key on the one-side entity becomes a foreign key on the many-side entity. For example, one customer can submit many order. Here one end is in customer side and the many end in order side. So the primary key of the customer entity becomes a foreign key in the order entity. Now map unary one to many relationships. These types are found mostly in recursive or self relationship. For example, one employee, actually manager, can supervise many employees. So we add a field supervisor ID as a foreign key to the employee table, which is actually referring to the primary key employee ID. Step 4. Map binary many-to-many relationships. Create a link table with the primary key of the two entities as its composite primary key. For example, employee and the project entity have a many-to-many relationships named works-on. So we create a link table named works-on and add the primary key of both entities as a composite key. Step 5. Map binary relationship one-to-one. Primary key on the mandatory side becomes a foreign key on the optional side. In our example, employee manage department relationship, it's optional for most of the employees to manage any department because the only manager can manage the department. But for the department, to have a manager is mandatory. So, according to the rules, the primary key of the employee table become a foreign key in the department table. Step 6. Map ternary relationships. One table for each entity and one link table for the associative entity. Here, patient treatment is a ternary relationship as three entities participate on it, which create an associative entity. So, we create a separate table for patient, physicians and treatment, and a separate table for patient treatment associative entity. Create a composite key composed of the primary key from the three entity. Step 7. Map supertype and subtype relationships. Create a table for the superclass and identify a primary key for it. Create a table for each subclass. Its primary key is the same as the one for the superclass entity, and add all other specific attributes to each subclass. For example, we have a superclass employee along with the three subclass full-time, part-time and consultant. So we create table for the superclass employee and create three separate table for the three subclasses, and each of the subclass table has the primary key same as the superclass, and adding rest of the specific attributes. That's all for this video. Happy mapping!